Okay, well, here are my two side pieces, and I went ahead and just, I'm finger joining this together instead of dovetailing. It's just going to be, this compound angle is just too hot for me to mark it all out and dovetail, so I think it's going to be just fine. It's going to look right on the as the base, but it's just what I've decided to do to save a little bit of brain power in this 105 degree weather. So what I'm getting ready to do here is, I see I've got all these cut here. And once I get all these cut and then trimmed up and cleaned up and everything, then I'll go ahead and mark my long pieces from that. Now I've got everything kind of cleaned back until to the point here where all I have to do is now come in and chop and scribe. But you know, I'll do that here. But I want to get this one done. So I wanted to just show you just how I'm going to do this. You know, I thought about trying to come up with a setup for the bandsaw, tilting the bandsaw table over to 20 degrees and, you know, blah, blah, blah. And I thought, you know, by the time I do that, I'm going to be done. I'm going to be done with this. So I've got everything scribed out here, you know, really accurately with a sharp tool and everything. What I want to do now is give myself a little channel passageway to get that dovetail saw started, especially since it's on this angle. And I've got the bevel going to the waste. Thank you. When you absolutely have to get medieval, you get this guy out. So this is the two-sided saw. It's rip on one side, cross cut on the other. So I'm going to rip down in here and connect that hole. So that's pretty close. You know, like I said, I just barked into it right here, but I'm gonna fix that. So now I'm ready to go to the chisels. But you can see that I'm using the actual piece that it lines up and is gonna give me the exact proper angle bevel for my for chopping to my scribed line here. So I didn't have to make another piece. I'm just clamping that down and getting after it.